What the hell? I think I was talked in to go live early somehow. So, you want to guess what time it is, you know? Be my guest, right? Yay. What do you want? Yes, Jim. So I'm live early. Whoops. Pushing wrong buttons already. I don't know, live already, yeah. I don't know. I got some nacho cheese. And I got some guacue. I got some taters. And over there, that's all fucked up container. I got some steak and some venison in the sous vide. Venison. I'm going to cut up this broccoli and steam it and then put it with the cheese sauce and then I'm going to do that. And then, you know what I mean, right? I'm early. What the fuck? Not even supposed to be here yet, right? Know what I mean? Not even supposed to be here yet, and I'm just here. I will tell you. I'm making a demi-glaze, but it ain't gonna be done tonight. it's quite a process. I made a reconstituted constituted whatever stock of beef, and I'm gonna boil it down probably tomorrow and get it right down to the nitty gritty. We got 2 hours and 15 minutes before that steak is done. Well, before it's done out there. And then we got to sear it quick and then we can eat it. So, yeah, I'm early. I don't know what else is. Oh, here. This is one of the bones. From the sock that I made. Put four of these in there. You can see.
You can see right through it, right?
Man, how about this way? But anyways. Yeah, that's what you want. All the marrow is into the sauce. And then it's strained out afterwards. It'll get strained one more time. It'll get cooked down, but we're going to use a little bit of it tonight just to make a little bit of a gravy. That'd be fantastic. So, stay tuned for all that shite. And that's about it. I mean, Frankie's, we got Jim. What are you doing, huh? What are you doing? You just think it's funny, don't you? Ha ha, look at me. I don't think he does. I don't think he thinks it's funny. I think he thinks you out pat him or make him up like this. Because he loves it. Okay. Yeah. But, anyways, should we do the rest of the show just like this? I don't think I'd get much cooking done. I don't think so, Jim. And eventually you're going to get heavy, you know. My arms are going to give way, and that's going to be the end of it. And you're just like, hey, you know, I like hanging out with you. Okay. Okay, come on. Have a cat, they said. Have two. Oh, I kind of on a diet now, though. They don't like me. But. Well, Jim doesn't like me. Abby's just like, Abby's probably like, more like, I need a diet. Jim's like, you got any more food? I'm just saying the truth, people. I'm just saying the truth. It's not sexist. I mean, how could it be? You're always going talking about cats. And I was on the side of the female, Mary-ish? Kind of? I don't know. I'm not going there anymore. Never mind. Forget I said anything. So, yeah, after we get done sous-viding the steak, we'll have to sear it. And we'll have to do a little basting with butter and stuff like that. I did try putting the stock that I made in the snow for a little while. And I realized even, you know, because what I'm doing is I'm getting the stock. So it cools down and it, told you, might as well do this wrong, just like that. And it separates the fat from the rest of it. The fat hardens on top, and then when it's ready, I'll take the fat off the top. That way the fat's separated, and then throw that in the garbage, and I'll cook it down even more. Get a real concentrated flavor, right, Jim? I know. I'm gonna take you out here and throw you in the wilderness and say, go run free. Dickhead. How many people call their animals dickheads? Don't jump up here anymore. You don't need to jump up here. No, we're not doing food either. Same thing, I'll give you a tiny bit. But that's it. That's all you're getting there. Chubby,
just kidding.
Didn't mean that. I could call his sister a little bit more, though. Abby's a little bit. Yeah, she's getting wide angle. Wide load. Whatever. No! Whatever. So. Yeah. Cats on a diet. Oh, BLB. NRT. I asked who lives up there. You know me, I had to ask. This is Jake's signature, this is Adam's signature, this is my signature. I don't even know if you can see that. Oh yeah, you can. The name of him, Ish.
Ish.
So, yeah, I mean, this is where we're at. Yeah, I was planning on 7, so I put that thing to that first. 7 will be 1 hour before that's done, and it'll take me 1 hour to do everything else, and you know. Our new staff said, yeah, sure. That's what they just said, I mean. Yo, uh-huh. 1 hour, yeah. Whatever. That's pretty funny, though. You gotta say that's funny. Well, using our roster for our taters. Best thing ever. I bet you I could do that with the cauliflower and do the whole, you know, keto diet thing. Keto. I know a guy named Keto. That's nothing new to diet, so. Yeah. 2 hours-ish. Had to go early, didn't I? Rain. It's all right. I'm good. I go early. Pretty much don't have anything else to do, I guess. So, anyway, though, gravy ought to be good out of that shit. Oh, man. The gravy ought to end up really good, actually. Just saying. Might as well cut up these broccoli heads. You can watch that, I guess. Right here. Right there. And there. Really yelling. There. It don't matter too much. You take a little bit of it off, but not a big deal. Happens. Put into a calendar. One's a little big. Oh, come on, that's cheating. Okay, I don't know what I'm talking about. Whatever. It's supposed to go that way, yeah. But, don't get me wrong, you can eat that if you want. Cook it up real good. I don't need to have that. It's all right. That's right. That one ended up with a little less yellow. Nice. Right into the calendar. That do. Okay, great. We did that. I'm here. So yeah. I mean, we got the broccoli. Couple of yellow beans down there that I don't like. Right through the ring light. Keep watching, because these are going to go right through the ring light and into the garbage. Ah, no. It went through the ring light. Didn't make it to the garbage. Yeah, I know. Actually, I'm going to burn it. You're on Facebook too, aren't you? Kind of weird that does that. So. This shit should be good. You know what I mean? I don't know how it can't be.
Mm-hmm.
So I had the leaf stock sitting up with that man. One of them, man. All right, guys, check this out. Hold on. Okay. You can see the fat starting to separate from everywhere. All this stuff right here, it's all fat. And once we get that to all congeal and break away, we can take that, put it through a strainer again. With the other one, which is fuller than that. And then we'll have all this fat strain from it, and we'll melt it down. We'll reduce it down to a nice demi-glaze. And then use it for whatever, freeze it, whatever you want to do. I'm going to freeze a bunch of it. And just like the, I still got a bunch of, just like the
chicken stock, I will have a bunch of flavor bombs.
For any beef at this point. This is cool. It's rich. It's tasty. I didn't go that far on the chicken. I should try that, though. Eventually, I can make it. The chicken stock the same way, right? Although the marrow and chicken bones is really small compared to what it is in beef. So, yeah, we're going to be waiting for a while here. Probably going to have to smoke some weed.
Weed.
Uh, not time for the R&D staff yet. Making my own schedule up now, boy. You know, dog. I like just saying shit out of random. Pesky no good. Dog. Just kidding.
I'm not really like that.
So what do I got here? I don't know what I got. I just don't know. More yellow in this broccoli than the top. Not liking that. All right, though, I'm guessing that. I'm just finding more yellow. I think I got pretty much under control though. Yeah. What's that? Good.
Be fine.
Song would say, "Wooey, wooey, wooey," or "I'm more fun." I don't
know, either one.
But, anyways, sous vide steak and venison. We will be searing them afterwards. It's a reverse sear method. They'll be cooked to
perfection.
And, yeah. The beef is a tenderloin that I had in my freezer. And obviously, I had the back strap in my freezer of the deer. I found it the other day and went, "Hey, look at that." So, hey, here I am, cooking it. And we're going to do some nice, creamy mashed potatoes or rice potatoes. And my phone's ringing.
Hello? What up?
You gotta keep it going.
Huh?
Me and fucking plastic and fucking steel over here watching.
Plastic?
Yeah.
Does it taste like plastic?
Yeah. Hey, color in that sign. Get a couple markers.
Yeah, I'll do that. I have to do that eventually. I don't have any markers on me right now, though.
You got any markers?
I ain't got no markers. I need a beer. I don't know why I'm standing out here without beer.
Get the beer. Go over to your RV. You want to see that nice pop?
You got any, well, you got any propane? I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, me either. All right, keep it real. We got 20 people watching you over
here. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Slow, yes. No, you don't. Work it out. You know, work it out. 20 people, I can't control them. You know, I'm all just screaming and shouting at our team. I can't control
them. Holy shit. It's fucking bad over there, isn't it? Hey. Yeah, it's bad over there. It's hell. So yeah, I'm good. Lots of time left. Let's see. I started to steam the broccoli. This broccoli. But that's going to be done pretty, pretty quickly, too. And we're going to, actually, we could start with the taters here shortly. The thing. Even though those aren't going to take an hour and yeah, 45 minutes or something. But we're here. I'm add some salt to this water here, which I'm gonna hit on myself. I'm gonna put it over here. Hi, Jim. I like using the regular mayonnaise fine salt for boiling. It's where I keep the food. And, you know, he's like, hey, can I get any of that? Look at the little son of a bitch. Okay, look, I will give you a little bit, but that's all you get. This is for Abby. This is for you, Jim. Of course, that attracts the rear Abby out real quick. Yes, I know. Starving kitties, yeah. Uh-huh. Telling ya. So we're gonna add some salty salts, Bill, to these taters. Perhaps that much. And all this water and these taters are gonna go. Okay, right here. Oh, look at that, a little bit. Salty watermelon icy. Yep, works. I think I'm going to that tomorrow.
Just kidding.
We're going to do this right on. Okay. Maybe. Shitty walk. Hey, you done about my walk, man? I got two of them, and they're awesome.
Okay, no, I'm not kidding. They are awesome. They aren't shitty.
Haters. We're gonna add a bunch of that shit. Or shit to that. In the end. Sorry. I can't talk. But we're gonna have to jockey around a little.
Jockey it up.
And, yeah. We're going to bounce around back and forth a little, you know, jockey. I don't know if you know who jockey is, but look at the ripples.
It's a ripple effect.
TLB, so much Jake, and so fun. Yes, I'm early. Yes, I'm early, so fun. Reen Reen TV talked me into it. I guess I'm early. Not that, you know, all the food's gonna be late. But. But you know, it is what it is. We are brewing some taters to make some rice taters. And I add some stuff to that. Probably not too much other stuff. Because the gravy that I'm going to make is make all that pop. I mean, I'm going to add butter, salt, pepper, and sour cream to these taters. And then I'm going to make the gravy out of the sauce or the stock that I made. And then tomorrow, I'm going to take that stock and I'm going to turn it into demi-glaze. If you would like to see me turn that stock into demi-glaze, I could do that live tomorrow if you want. But only if you want. No, I mean, if you don't want me to show it on a live thing, then I won't, but. Probably will anyways, but hey. What y'all drinking? I'm drinking some hoop tea. Hoop tea. Yeah, hoop tea. Hoop tea, hoop tea, hoop tea. Just kidding. No, I'm not kidding. That's actually why I'm drinking, yes. It's a variety pack. And it's something I was going to pick this over. I looked at this and the Dunkin' Donuts thing. And I picked the Dunkin' Donuts. Now I'm trying this. So, it's pretty good. It's not bad. Not a fan, I'm going to say. Ooh, there's the bowl. I have no idea what I'm doing. Rombo. Got to touch the bowl. Thank you. Rinse my box with. Oh, rip it all over, damn blade. Holy shite. That's a rolling ball! So, I got both the cheddar and the nacho when I went there last time. And I was going to make nachos with this. I might still go, have to go get one tomorrow, right? Yeah. They're pretty cheap. Not bad. They taste good. I'm not going to say it's healthy for you. Nothing's healthy for you, and if you eat too much of anything, it's not healthy. But I was reading the ingredients for this and the regular same brand cheddar cheese. The only difference is this one has whey, which is kind of a cheese. Not waste, but a cheese byproduct. Whey is a cheese byproduct after you get done using milk to make the cheese. What you're left with is whey. So this one uses whey as a first ingredient, and the other one uses milk. Or water. I can't remember now. But, yeah. That's the only difference. Plus, it's got a lot of ingredients. I'm not into, like, half of them, but, you know, it's pretty good. I'm just going to say it's pretty good. Fuck it. What do you want me to say? I'm not your average health show here. I mean, it's average. Yeah, it's average cheese food. Yeah, definitely. It says cheese sauce on it though, so it's got to be a little bit more. But it's good stuff. I don't care what you say. It's better. This is better than Cheese Whiz. This is better than Velveeta. This is better than all that stuff. Unless you make it yourself, this is better than all that stuff. Because I can make this, and I can probably make it better, but it's a lot of time, and you know, I have to buy more ingredients than what this can is going to be. So, hey, I'm good with that. What that is. Good enough for me. C is for cooking. You ever see that? C is for cooking? Damn, Sesame Street. The old days. Oh, yeah. So, cooking that, where are we at? Okay, we're just over an hour in. We got an hour and a half to go with that. 6:42, I'm early. I told you. I got everything set up though. Need some ball is right on ball tonight. Oh, yeah. Doing this. Now, I will say,
we'll have a little combo here. Let's have a little combo.
The last time I did this with the Benny and the that thing, it was the best venison I ever had. Just so soft, so melting, so beautiful, so good tasting. Curious if this is going to be the same way. I mean, it was nice. It's a nice piece of backstrap. Straight up in that area where there's not much of the silver skin. And it's, yeah. It's really nice. Although I'm willing to cut around that silver skin a little bit too, so. But. I'm curious how it compares between the steak and the, well, the steak. I'm curious how it compares with the steak. Because everything's done the same way. Salt, pepper, garlic powder. That's it. No need to put anything else on that shite. When I make the gravy, maybe a little bit might get mixed in. When I make the demi-glaze, probably a lot of that is going to get mixed in. I can freeze that shit, and that'll be the real flavor bomb. But like I said, I probably won't be able to finish that until tomorrow. I'm thinking it's going to be pretty damn good. I mean, gotta smoke some damn weed while I'm waiting, too, you know? And, see? Peach. Where's peach?
I thought it was mango.
I must, yeah. I've already tried that, not thought about it. Or, never mind. I'm gonna try the peach here. Yeah. First time trying the peach. See, the peach has a little bit of artificial. Yes. I'm not too much of a fan of that. Everything else up to this point wasn't bad, but this... It's not off-putting. I can drink it. This is not the best one they have in that pack. It almost tastes like artificially.
A little bit. Although, could be just the peach and just changing flavors, you know what I mean?
I gotta smoke some ice dish shite. So, yeah.
Production value.
Okay. Every once in a while, you gotta take a hit. It's just what the doctor said. Not your doctor, that's my doctor. My doctor says that. You do what your doctor says. I'm not telling you what to do. Oh, shit. Here we go. Gonna get in trouble for telling you what to do. I didn't tell you what to do, by the way. You don't have to do that. Do what your doctor says to do. Of course, I don't have a doctor, obviously. He told me to quit drinking, so I don't have a doctor. Is it true? I'm just saying, those aren't even close to done yet. Not done yet, hey. That's all right, because I got an hour and some day. But, so, cooking with a sous vide. Kind of interesting. I mean, I've done it before. You guys have seen me do it before, I know. But it's still like, that is the ultimate easy bake. Just push the fucking buttons and but you got seared at the end, but hey. And I broke my torch, so I got to get into one of them. I hit it on the way by and it fell down. And whatever. Horse fucking torch. I can get a better one though. I'm not getting a crazy one. Dude, if you've ever, dude, I just called you guys dude, by the way. If you've ever looked up torches to buy like that, like flamethrowers, you can get some cheap ones, and then you can get some fucking really expensive ones. But you go. You have to hold on with two hands because it's so powerful. Just kidding. I don't think they sell anything like that. Yeah. Nice, MLD. Good to see you watching. Yeah, he's getting there. Yes. See, when you can do this, they're not done yet. They're getting there, though. That's terrible, right? I don't know. I'm gonna have to move you guys over to get the shots I want for when we're doing all the other stuff that's gonna come out. Because this is just the start of it. I mean, truthfully, what is it? Yeah, it's 7 minutes from seven, so yeah, I'm right on time to what I thought would be the way it would work out. So here we are. So like I said, though, sous vide machine is kind of like push and go. That just let it do its thing. Seared at the end. But that's not to say you take a broiler pan and you put some steaks on a broiler pan and you put them in the oven for at 350 for until they become 130, 125, 130 internally. Pull them out and sear them. But this you find that so it becomes a little bit softer and is edge to edge medium rare or medium whatever you want to cook it. It's edge to edge. I mean, we're gonna use a pan because I don't have a flame already, but we're gonna use a pan to sear it, and so that's gonna make a little bit more heat. So it's going to cook just that little bit more, so there might be a little tiny bit of, not edge to edge, but overall, it's a great way to cook steaks. I personally will always love steaks off the Weber grill, but if you don't have access to a Weber grill, or you live in an area like I do, like the rest of us do, where it's fucking snow, good job for you. I got a good joke for you. I made this up, by the way, so all these people come up during this fall and then go, oh, look at the colors of the leaves up here. Oh, it's so beautiful. Oh, this is so nice. Oh, it's so great. I love this. And they take dollar pictures and it's fucking beautiful and everything's wonderful. And then they go home to their place back in the south. The locals up here are like, oh, look how beautiful. And then we're stuck in the cold snow fucking winter until summer. So yeah, that was my joke of the day. Sorry if it wasn't that good, I guess. It's true, though. You guys all know it. We look at them fall leaves and we say, oh shit, here we go again. You know you do. Don't tell me you don't. It's been going an hour and 18 minutes. These cedars are just about there, too. So I'm probably just going to end that. And we're going to let them sit in that water for a little bit. And we're going to transfer That was a... You can check out this. Steamer. I bought this a while ago. I got three of these things. Two of them have double trays. You've seen them before on the channel. And I got a little tiny one. I mean, this thing's great. You want to steam whatever? Yeah. Three, maybe four people. I put all that broccoli right in here and steam it right up. So that's probably four servings worth. Anyways, maybe three. All three, I should say. So, yeah, cool little thing there. You can never have enough of these steamers if you like doing veggies and you got family things and you want to do the whole meal. You know, steak, protein, starch, and veggie. So we got our protein going, we got our starch going. This will be our veggie until we go to the nacho cheese land. Which, yeah. I can't get enough of that shit. I asked the R&D staff, what should I do for veggie? Well, how about some more broccoli and cheese sauce? Okay. Trust my heart. So here we are, doing more. And I just happened to have this sitting over there, and I said, you know what? That'll be great. And I think Jonathan and Mike are doing a little Super Bowl thing tomorrow. So I'm going to go over there and enjoy the company and the fun spirits and you know, Super Bowl-ish. And take their swim! I mean, just kidding. I didn't mean it like that. No. Holy shit. Yeah. I didn't mean that. Whatever. It's hilarious. Oh, the whole thing. I'll tell you that. So anyways. Got our nacho sauce. Cheese sauce. Yeah. Jim, what are you doing? I gotta throw the mouse Jim a bunch more times to get him in shape. The rare Jim needs to be, you know, in shape a little. Of course, the rare Abby, even rarer Abby. I throw the mouse, she goes. I'm serious. You doubt me, but you know, I live my life. See what I see. Okay. How much longer do I have to do this? So over an hour. So over an hour before this shit's good. Ah. So, yeah, I mean, I could go over all kinds of cooking equipment that I think the home cook should have. I could go all over that, and I could tell you what I think, and but truthfully, you've seen everything I use pretty much already live, so I don't feel the need to have to go over the products or the stuff that I have to make everything work. I mean, besides video stuff, which I got some more stuff that I need to get, which down the road, keep building. The biggest thing is, you know, you go for anything like this, you go for anything like that, you do anything in life, go, hate to use a cliche, but go big or go home. Either do it or don't. You don't have to go. I mean, I guess you don't have to go, baby. But you do have to do it. That's all I'm going to say about that. I didn't get into that conversation anyway. Oh, yeah, Jim, that's right. Jim, you need to lose weight. Just kidding. Sorry, Jim. I didn't mean it. Abby needs to lose a little bit more weight than you. I don't know what to tell you. But yeah, that if I could hold her up compared to him, and you see that, you'd be like, okay, Abby needs to lose some weight. That is a normal thing that happens to some a lot of female cats. When they get fixed, they gain a little weight. Happens quite a bit. Like Sadie, the R&D staff's kitty Sadie, we call her football because she's about this long and she's about that wide. That might be a little exaggerating, but. Whatever. Puck it. No, feel fun. You are you actually? You can't swear, can you? You're using your fucking name to fucking spell it the fuck out, right? Fudging. Sorry. I didn't mean to do all that. Okay, so the nacho cheese sauce here. Only 280 calories for the whole can. It's got like zero of everything else. 6% fat. Got some stuff on it. Whatever. Oh, here we go. We missed it. What time is it? Does anybody know what time it is? Time is it? You know I'm talking to you. That's right, it's cook time! Hey! Woo! We're here. Doing nothing but hanging out. Waiting for our taters to be ready to be mashed or whatever we're doing. Waiting for our beef to be done. BB. Definitely got an hour left. Hour left on the BB. That means almost an hour left of having food. Yeah, I'd say an hour and a half. 40 minutes. 3 hours. 3 hours later. Whatever. Damn it. Everybody's picking on me. Oh, shit. I just picked on myself. Fuck. Oops. I'm going to take a hit. I'm going to take another fucking hit and say fuck it. I don't know what that is there. Insano. Apex Twins. What? I'm not even going to try. So, Sabid, you're gonna see it's the way to go. You want perfect steak? You got family? Family of four, easily fed by that. Protein. You can put potatoes in it. You can put anything you want into it. You got a couple of them. That whole setup cost me $100. You get three of them things, you're cooking a whole 5-course meal. When you're not there. Just turn it on. Let it go. Come home. Oh, yeah. It's done. Trust me, this is something that I if you guys go on to YouTube and you go to sous vide everything, you'll be introduced to this guy Guga, who I've talked about Guga on my channel before. Shout out to Guga. Guga taught me lots of things. Especially about sous vide, though, which is why I have one. I haven't used it in a while. I know. It's not Like I said, you can go out to Weber Grill, and I can go out to Weber Grill and make a steak that's just as good, just about. It's got the flavor, doesn't have the soft texture. When you're talking about doing it with venison, that last time, if it works out the same way as that, I'm sold. And I will put that up against any other venison at that point that I've ever eaten in my life. So, here it is, sous vide. Go to sous vide everything. Check out Google. He's a cool guy. Shout out the guy. He's got more subscribers than I do. He's damn near famous. He lives in Miami, and yeah. Check that out, though. And if you want, if you're into cooking by having the ease of it in some ways, and liking shit come out perfectly in that way, sous vide is definitely for you. For you. It's basically just a circulator of water. And sous vide, roughly translated, means a cooking in a vacuum. Basically, taking your meat or whatever you want, and putting it in a vacuum bag, and then cooking it in water. That's it. That's what it is. We've gone over this before, I know. I'm just about to try to drink some fucking natural cheese. That's not my cheese. This is hoopty. I'm going to have to drink a lot of this stuff now just so I can go around saying hoopty. You know, it's our role. To drink a mango without realizing I drank a mango and just not taste it, you know. But I got a mango now. I was curious on that one, actually, when I bought it. And I drank one and was like, I didn't even know I drank one. Didn't pay attention, I guess. Par for the course. Let's try it.
I do remember this.
That's the best one. Yep. I like that. I kind of like that. Let's try it again. Yep, Yeah, that's the best one out of them all. The other ones, the regular, the original one, just tastes like iced tea. This one has that smooth mango. If you've ever had a nice juicy mango, you know what I'm saying. The other ones are a little sharp and a little bit peach. The peach one and the watermelon one are a little sharp and they're a little little chemically tasting, if you know what I mean. A little artificially tasting, I should say. They're probably not. I mean, this whole thing, they got quite the label here, but with anything that you add alcohol to, it kind of takes up that flavor. The mango takes it very well. It's like, probably said this one before, but I'll say it again. It's like they don't make a Jack and Coke. They don't make a Jack and Pepsi. They don't make a rum and Pepsi. They make a Jack and Coke. They make a rum and Coke. Because if you taste Coke to Pepsi, you'll find that Coke has that way more cola flavor and stands up way better to the alcohol. Pepsi doesn't have that. Which is the appeal of Pepsi, where people can drink more of it or whatever. But if you've ever tried a Jack and Coke to a Jack and Pepsi, you will know there's a big difference there. And it's astonishing that there is, because it's hard to tell Jack or Pepsi compared to Coke blindfolded. Yeah, I can, because I drink a lot of Pepsi or Coke, and I just never liked Pepsi. I tasted it, I've had it, I never liked it. I know what it tastes like. But a lot of people, the normal person, but you add a little alcohol to it, you'll be able to tell, because a Coke stands out better than a Pepsi. And if you doubt it, try it for yourself. You know what I mean? It's the truth. That's why, if you've ever had a true Long Island iced tea, if you add Pepsi instead of Coke at the end, you won't get that same Long Island iced tea flavor. You won't get it. You just can't get it. You need the Coke. That's why it specifically calls for Coke. So that's my take on soft drinks, but what we got? We got a little while left. So, you know, like I said, no need to leave them in the water anymore. Now, just so you guys know, I mean, I'm going to leave. That much water in there. That much starch water. You want to leave that in there. Just because when you start to get butter, and if you put cream in it or sour cream, you get an emulsification with the starchy water that just makes it way back. Trust me, leave a little bit of water there, man. Don't drain your potato taters like that. Totally dry. Or if you do, conserve the water that you strain out and add it as needed. I find that that much pretty much does the perfect amount in that way. For what I am, for what I do, you know what I mean? For what these come out to be. And, you know, it's always hard. That's your taste it yourself. I know, you guys don't know. Could be shit, and I'd be like, that's the best thing. You know what I mean? So, I laugh, but you know it's true. Have you ever seen some of the cooks on fucking YouTube? Look up worst cooks on YouTube. It's fucking scary. And the worst thing is, they have more fucking subscribers than I do. Because they fucking suck. It's funny sometimes. I'm smoking weed and shit. I don't even know. I don't know what you're talking about there, KGS. I mean, you know where I live? I don't know how to do any of that shit. I see what you type. I'm like, yeah, how the, what, huh? No. I get, well, anyways. There he is. What do you want, man?
Yo, we're doing a mashup. We got a new plan with some main bag plans. Everything you say is like a good rap song. Record it, man. You're going to get stopped.
Okay. So what do you want me to say?
Just real, man.
I'm just being a rap star, you know. I'm gonna. Can I get to number one and then retire?
Probably. I mean.
One hit. I don't care. I'll be a one hit wonder. Fuck it.
Yep. If anyone wants to know, check out the song that I put in your description and that thing. Yo, if you mash it up on your live, they can't really charge you for it or make you have a problem. But boy, does it mash up good. We're sitting here watching your live where you're blowing up. That's all I'm saying. Check it out. See you on
the next. Yeah. Probably tomorrow. But.
And we still have you playing too. I had to mute you right now, so it wasn't time for you. But yeah, if you literally open two tabs,
well, where are you? Someday I'll have a producer. And he'll stop fucking calling me. Yes, I produce that, obviously. I have to produce everything I have my own. I'm mine. And I'm my own. But. We're growing. I'm growing. As knowledge and as a channel and as everything that has happened at this point, it's going to take a couple years, but I'm growing. Not stopping. I will say that. That is a key point. I am not stopping. Something's going to happen, right? So, anyways. we got our lovely taters here. We're at 150. 40 minutes from searing the off the beast. Deering off the beast. Just kidding. It's kind of weird, isn't it? Put that right in my rap song. I'm steering off the beast. Right? Come on, that's good. Right? Maybe not. Whatever. I don't care. Okay, look. This is what we're doing here. We got this. And we are starting to run fast. If you've ever worked one of these, you gotta lock the cartridge in. It's butane, blah, blah, blah. I showed you that before. Steaming. We want to get that heat right out there. Taters. I think I got. Hold on, Phil. Jim, do you got any taters in here?
Oh, yeah.
There's not much left. But yeah, I got some. Nah, those are, he's going to say, those are potato puffs. just kidding. Those are the best fucking tater tots you can get. Sorry. Unless I try to make my own, those are the best tater tots you can get. Well, these taters that I got here are just hanging out, waiting for the ricer extraordinaire and the mixture and everything to come together. Which means you're going to sit there for a little bit, yes. Which is fine. Because if they cool off a little bit, I can heat them back up and then make the whole thing. Same with this broccoli. I'm going to steam this broccoli. And I'm going to get it steamed to a point, and then I'm going to let it sit until 10 minutes from service time. I can take this cheese and put it in a bin with the broccoli and heat it all up. I mean, it's not rocket science, Jim. You hear me? Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you do.
Here's that.
You know that, Jim. Okay, I'm in here. One more time. One more time. So anyways, yeah.
I'm waiting for that to
hear my body. We're waiting for that to become good. And you know.
Jim, you're my pointer.
Your tail, you're my pointer. That. Tell you guys, this ain't half gas, it says. I'm just kidding. I love my kitties. But I don't know if I always really love my kitties. Come on, Jim.
Let me fix that spot on your fur there, buddy.
See, I don't know what this music is, but if you could give me a fucking anything, yeah, that's it's still on. And I will give credit to whoever's playing right now. I can't. Hold on. Yeah, where was I? By somebody, I don't know. That's good. I give credit to him. Yeah, it's a fucking song called Where Was I by, I don't even know, somebody. Way to give credit, buddy. Dumbass. Just kidding. I'm calling myself a dumbass. Oh, this is kind of fun tonight, huh? Been one of them moods, right? Check that out, though. One of them moods is getting me some good food. Foodie food. So, this is gonna steam. Just for a little bit. Put the taters in that one. Don't fall. Good thing we're home cooked if I can learn. It is fucking mise en place. Learn that phrase? then use it. If you ever plan on going to the cooking in a restaurant, you'll have a head start. A bit of a head start. Not saying tall, but mise en place. Yeah. Be ready for the next step, basically. Prep. Everything is prep. You're only as good as you prep. I can say it over and over again. But that's what mise en place insinuates. I would say. Birdman. Oh. And you gotta swear shit. I mean, and probably do a little drugs, take a little alcohol. Wow. That just escalated, didn't it? Okay, so we're gonna steam those. We're a half an hour from checking some shit out at you. It's from, you know, never mind.
Half an hour before it's done.
So, we are going in here. We are all in. That looks awesome, right? Yep. I just let all the steam out. That's not, I don't recommend doing that, but sorry. I just had to show you real quick. These are gonna get the fork tender, and be pulled. Not even fork tender, close to fork tender, almost to fork tender. And I did go off to get a thing, and I didn't. One of those things. I got out there and I said, what the hell am I doing? And I walked back in here. Yeah, paper towels are out there, buddy. If you wanted paper towels, you gotta go out there. So, yeah. That's what I was going out that far.
What's that weed? Huh?
So, anyways, you know, that's getting done. That's probably just about done.
And I got this fucking row of fucking paper towels, man. Look at this thing.
That thing's huge, right?
And I don't know what, you know, what you got, but I got way bigger, probably.
I don't know.
And I just so happened to find this moon on the fucking ceiling as I was walking by it.
I was like, hey.
I should use that just to fucking get rid of it, you know? So here I am talking like a jackass. And we're using the fucking rest of the boom. Now, what do you think, man? So, what do you think? What do you think? What do you think? Just kidding.
Jim. Wait, wait.
Yeah. I'm addicted to this shit, man. Addicted.
Okay. That was sad. One was sad. One was that, right?
Yes.
Huh. Alright, these are probably great cupping clothes. Where'd my fucking fork go? Oh. Yeah. So, broccoli coming off. Now I feel kind of weird. I think I just huffed too much fucking helium.
The free part is like an armrest talk like that. There it is.
Yeah. Whatever. Oogie D and I used to talk that way back and forth. Some people didn't like it. So anyways, yeah, what we got? We got our broccoli done. All we have to do is melt the cheese sauce and get that in there. That shite's done, man. Shite is done. So, then I got ricey's taters. And I got 20 minutes to do it all. Okay. Time to assemble, I guess that's right. Here you go. Alright, so. I got my cooked taters. If you... let me put it this way. Let's say this episode... Because instead of doing it live, let's say my episode starts right here. I got cooked potatoes. I got cooked broccoli. Got everything. That. And that's why I do it live. Fuck it. I'm going to do it live. See? Is it Bill Maher? I need to talk to that guy because I need his quote. Like, I need to have it. That's mine now. All right, Paco, we'll do it live. Anyways. We're going to take all this cheese. Cheesy cheese whiz. I don't like cheese whiz either. I like this cheese. It's the best. Or the big can. You can get big cans of this shit. Big cans. But I'd rather have this than any of them. It tastes better. Just saying, you know. You don't have to agree with me. Whatever. Get it right out of there. Oh, yeah. There it is. That's all you get. That's all you fucking get. See how I take my recycling, mofos? Just kidding. Not really, but yeah, I always do that. And restaurant life, I can't. That's how we used to do it. We're getting there. Woohoo! Where was I going from here? Could be a thing. All right.
First, we're going to go with this.
I was gonna say some shit, but I don't know. Yeah. Let's turn that down. You don't want much heat for this, obviously. Thank you. containers here. We're going to go in this ricer. Yeah, you can see it. You gotta really get into that shit. Yeah. The thing just busts right out of the bottom. That didn't work, right? Yeah. I'll get it here. More needed for that. No more need in there. Natural has a little bit more of a almost a spicier thing going on. That even though I don't see there's no other spices that they add, so I
They might add to other spices, but they don't mention that really. But
definitely has a kicker. Kickier.
Oh, that's good though. That's fucking really good.
Flop of butter.
Flop.
Yes, that's technical. Yep. That's just kidding. Hey. Yeah. And of course, flop of sour cream. Flop of Booski.
There may be a little bit more. But...
might have been a little bit more sour cream than mine, but anyway. Yeah, not really. Yeah. Actually, it's going to end up being just nice. Oh, yeah. Thinking this thing should have stayed in the van. Ah, man, thing. That thing is getting a little cold. Hear it out. Yep. Yep. Alright, so there we go. Hey.
Oh, sorry.
So,
I better go check on the iron newsstand.
I think there's usually, yeah, understaffed. Definitely overpaid and unworked.
I mean,
put some hood heavy cream in that. In. Guys, keep an eye on that. Make sure Jim don't fuck with anything. Right?
All right. Yeah. There we are. Yeah. Burnt that, didn't I? Burn the shit out of that, by the way. Done that didn't happen, right? Right, right. Yeah. Just kidding. You know what, though? That's probably best tasting stuff ever. That's right, right? It's the hottest tasting thing. It's hot. Don't taste bad. It doesn't taste bad at all. Our sous vide here is done. Let's pull these out. What? Burn the shit out of Obama and whatever. Yep. And actually, that's not bad. Just saying, that's not bad. Ha. That's fine, isn't it? All right, so. Venison, beef. Yep, yep.
All right, so that one was the only one with a little bit of juices in there. Kind of interesting, right? Cow juices, deer, no juices. Then it's from the filet, which is like, you know, the leanest cut. But you can see you don't have any color, right?
Right, 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 right.
You're gonna pat them dry. Get everything patted dry. Drier they are, the better they take the sear at this point. Probably fit all of those in that one pan, so we're gonna go with it. Now this, and this, I'm going to tell you to all the medium well, blah, 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 for all the people that go into that, this is a part you put the pan, you can cook it to whatever you want at this point. But this is your base temperature. Let me show you what I mean by that. So we got the oven here. We're gonna start the fire right up. We're gonna use a neutral. This is grapeseed oil. Not gonna go too heavy in there, but we're gonna go just enough to coat it. Just enough to get it all coated. Alright, so we gotta get this going here. Also, gotta get some kind of. Actually, I don't need it. Okay, I'm gonna tell you guys straight up. These don't really need that. Oh. They don't need anything. Of course, this doesn't need anything. Well, I think I'm gonna skip the gravy, actually. I mean, I could make an awesome gravy with that stuff. But I think I don't know. We'll check it out at the end when I get done with all this. Because everything here that I'm not needing a tall gravy at this point. Everything's good. I mean, although I will put a little bit into this and to coat at the end.
I'm just hearing, right?
So I can't eat. I can't stop eating. That's other stuff. Huh. Oh, look at that. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I did that. Hey, Mike. Okay.
Okay, I'm going to say it's first thing. See your book into that. And it's read. But the seminar about the same. Seminar about this thing's going to come off here. Yeah. I don't think it's much more. I mean, I have found the venison is a little bit better. Being overcooked by him.
Hey.
You know what I mean? I mean, those are pretty good. Most people wouldn't think of doing this year. I mean, truthfully. Well, no, we aren't ready to cut that out for the week. Aha. As I keep on eating these taters, All right, so I gotta remember what I was trying to do here. There's some butter. Oh yeah, that's right. Not about that much butter. What's going on? Not even having the heat on, but eating this shit. Yeah.
We're gonna let that melt down. Still alive, all right. Alright. So, anyways. Said done. Everything rested. Got the butter. Got the hiccups. Oh, son of a bitch. Got the hiccups. We'll go one more just to appease the god. So, I have pizza gods with two of them fucking things. Let's go with that. See what happens. In the meantime, she wants to see that. Oh, shit. Let's get rid of all this bullshit anyway. Except for that.
Check that out. Good.
Look at that. Tell me that's not bad. Tell me there's something wrong with that. Tell me there's something wrong with that, right? If you can tell, if you can tell me there's something wrong with that, then you're Phil, shut the fuck up. Just kidding. You would say
there's nothing wrong with that,
Mr. Phil. Mr. Phil, you would say that, Phil Bonnevie. Yeah, you know. You know that I hit it on that. That's fucking beautiful, gorgeous stuff. And that's cow. I mean, we're going to throw that shit down. We're going to throw that shit down. Right after we throw this shit down. What was it adding to the sauce? I mean, oh, I don't remember. I don't even know where I'm going with it, but whatever. Thank you.
Whoa. Okay, so yeah,
money there as much as I can.
I have to add one more spoon here.
There's the mixer. There is the ready. Sauce, ready. Call it what you want. Is that some kind of master for that? Yeah. Okay, let's check this out, right?
I mean, come on.
Don't have anything that you can go from the other way. Okay. Anyway, let's do it, right?
Let's just fucking do this, right?
I'm gonna turn this back on. Okay. We're gonna get this one out of the way, obviously. Could have gone a little there. Okay, look at that. Look at that. Okay. So I need to see.
Need one of these. Probably go this way. Just make it safer. Oh, oh, oh. Okay, okay. Okay, that's all I need to see. Right? Look at that stuff. Okay. Let's try it, right? I mean, the proof is in the pudding. I mean, if it doesn't taste very good, or if it's fucking fucked up, you don't want to eat it, right?
Right, right.
So, let's try it. Fucking tripod. I haven't found one of these things that's durable. But you got, you know, fucking $300 for the fucking thing. But anyway, hey. Yeah. Okay, good. Let's get you back out there. Get back on there. Right. All over the place, huh?
Yeah.
All right, so. Anyways, you saw me cut up the pieces. I don't know if the gravy is working too well with what I got going on here. Yeah, watch this. More than fucking six ways to skin a cat, right? Run that shit through a strainer. So good. I might not want that one. Either way, let's try this. Okay. Beef. I know what that's going to taste like. Yeah, me. Huh.
That's good. That is good. So, yeah, but whatever. Dear, listen. Okay. The deer tenderloin is a little bit deer. Like the cow tenderloin, the tenderloin of a cow is a little bit more tender, which is to be expected. I mean, number one, a cow and a deer, they move a lot differently, and a lot, but number two, a cow tenderloin is the actual tenderloin, whereas the deer backstrap is more of the, what would be considered the New York strip and prime rib cuts. But to put an overall, I mean, I'm just going to dredge this shit into that. Be like, let's try that. That is delicious. And I'm going to do the same thing with this. I didn't like that as much. I'm going to tell you straight up truth here. RTTV. I didn't like that as much. I thought the I thought the venison had way more of a complex flavor in that way. I mean, that was good. I don't know. I think the venison takes it. That, don't get me wrong. Is it soft? Dipping into that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
don't know. I think Venison. Okay. Sous vide, try it for yourself. It's pretty freaking good. I'm going to say that. All right. Love you guys. Thanks for watching all that jazz. Subscribe if you're not. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah. Blah, blah. Love you guys. Yeah. Yeah, I just want to say, you know, I love you guys. Just saying. I'll see you guys on the next one.